This video will focus on a solar tube, a 60-foot long balloon available from Educational Innovations for about $14. Solar tubes are useful for exploring the ideal gas law and Archimedes Principle. We will fill the solar tube with a leaf blower and then tie it off, making sure there are no leaks so that the amount of air in the balloon remains constant over time. Note that the balloon sinks and lies on the ground due to the weight of the balloon's plastic. This situation involves Archimedes' principle, which says that there is an upward force of buoyancy on an object equal to the displaced fluid, which can be either a liquid or gas. Adding up all forces in the vertical direction, upward forces being positive, the upward force of buoyancy is not sufficient to support the downward weight of the air inside the balloon and the weight of the plastic. Thus, the balloon falls to the ground where it can be supported by an additional force from the ground. We can use an infrared camera to measure the temperature of the balloon immediately after it is filled. Now note that the sun is shining on the balloon. What do you think will happen over time?
Let's check our understanding with a peer instruction question. Classroom students should follow normal procedures or instructor guidelines. Viewers not in a classroom should record your vote and explain your reasoning on a piece of paper. Please pause this video and answer the question.
Realize that a black object will absorb more light and heat up faster than lighter colored objects around it, which are reflecting much of the incident light. Thus, the temperature of the balloon and the air inside it will rise. We will use time-lapse video to speed up the next few minutes for the balloon, and we quickly see that the balloon rises up off of the ground. Once again, we will use an infrared camera. Note that the temperature has risen. How can we use basic physics to explain why the balloon rose? Gases expand when heated, as described by the ideal gas law. The ideal gas law in this circumstance can be written as pressure times volume is proportional to temperature. So, as temperature increases, the air pressure inside the balloon will increase, exerting greater pressure on the walls of the balloon, and it will expand, increasing its volume. So, the balloon is now larger than it was when it was lying on the ground. As the temperature has risen, both the pressure, pushing on the inside of the balloon, and the volume of the balloon have increased. Note that an up-close view of the balloon allows us to see how smooth the outer surface of the balloon is now that the gas inside has expanded. Thus, the force of buoyancy is now larger because the balloon is larger and is displacing more air. In fact, the force of buoyancy is larger than the combined weight of the balloon and the air inside, until an additional force of restraint is provided by the demonstrator. Note that Archimedes' principle is indirectly responsible for many important aspects of astronomy. More teaching materials are available on the web at astro.unl.edu.